You are watching UNICEF television. With returnees flooding into rank from Sudan, UNICEF, in collaboration with its partners, has been crucial in providing basic shelter and services for those arriving at a town isolated by heavy rains and lack of infrastructure.
We still received a lot of returnees from the northern different states. Now, we have a lot of problems like sanitation and health, and food and shelters.
As many of those arriving are children, their health is one of the key priorities for UNICEF. A key part of that is the immunization program.
Here we have a small clinic which started running 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago. And why the clinic started is because there were so many returnees and they needed medical attention. We can anticipate measles outbreak because people are staying together. So to prevent the measles outbreak, we are giving the children measles vaccine and also giving the children under 5 years mosquito nets.
Malnutrition is another serious condition that UNICEF has to be wary of.
Okay. Malnutrition is really an issue in Rain County, especially this time because of the higher influx of returnees. There started to be shortage of food in the market. And though it had been an agricultural area, but most of the farmers were from the north, and it's like they are going back.
The main reason why the rate of malnutrition is increasing is the reoccurrence of chronic diarrhea. This is mostly due to the water and poor sanitation. Also, they have seen that some of the children are weaned before they reach the age 18 or 24 months. They are weaned at an early age, like a year. These children suffer from malnutrition severely. These are the main reasons they have discovered an increase in malnutrition.
One of the biggest health concerns is dirty water and unhygienic conditions in the camp. UNICEF and its partners have been providing clean water and latrines to combat this problem. However, matching the supply with the rate at which the returnees are arriving is a big challenge.
There is a problem with water. Everywhere is overcrowded and we cannot get access to water. We have been here for 1 month now and the water issue is a real problem.
For Mina site, we have so far completed 20 latrines. And the target is 50 latrines. There are also hand washing facilities adjacent to latrines so that they can access this unit, the users. And this line is the line that we've identified for latrines construction along the camp in Mina here.
After dealing with the urgent requirements, UNICEF has been helping children to cope with the trauma of the experience. By building child-friendly spaces, they've already helped more than 2,000 children.
These places have helped children cope with emergencies because when we came, children could only sit in their hut or play in the water. UNICEF has helped us a lot because at least now children come and play here and they socialize and interact and make friends.
This place provides us with shade, so when it is too hot, we can sit in there. Also, when we want to learn, they bring some lessons for us.
With more returnees on the way, UNICEF's Chief of Field Office in Upper Nile explains how they will manage.
The current season is the rainy season, and one of those critical things that is required, for example, at rank, is the issue of shelter. We do foresee that as the decongestion takes some time to take form and shape, people will be staying for a longer time. So that means for UNICEF, we have to raise enough funds to support the activities that we have installed to keep them running, and also to cater for any additional number of returnees as they come.
As the number of returnees in Renk continues to grow, more effort and resources will be required from UNICEF and its partners to continue the delivery of humanitarian assistance to the affected population. This is Shalin Poppet reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org, Unite for Children.